Earlier this month, the Army finally selected an optic, or a fire control, for their new prototype weapon that hasn't actually hit soldiers yet. That optic is called the Next Generation Squad Weapon Fire Control, and they chose the company Vortex Optics, which is also working with Sheltered Wings, a subsidiary, to create this optic. Essentially, it's going to be a computer atop of the new weapon. Now, the weapon itself, the Next Gen Squad Weapon, is still scheduled for a down select between two different prototypes later this year in 2022, but the optic has been selected, and it's going to provide all kinds of new capabilities. Just a few of the features that will be in the new fire control include a variable magnetic optic, an etched reticle, a laser rangefinder, a ballistics computer, visible and infrared aiming lasers, a digital overlay, and wireless communications to communicate with goggles and other systems for data collection and sharing. So that's a lot of high-tech stuff, but what does that mean for the soldier in the field? Well, essentially, instead of kind of guessing where your target is on old open iron sights and hoping that you're adjusting appropriately for windage or for elevation, the computer's gonna lock you right into target. And with some of the new software they're including in the goggles called Rapid Target Acquisition, the two will marry up, link up, and pair together. And just like you're a fighter pilot or you're a tank commander or you're a gunner on a Bradley, you basically will be walked into the target with the computer-aided marksmanship tools. So essentially, you can basically maybe get first shot, first kill, first time. So this new optic will eventually replace the rifle combat optic, the close combat optic, and the machine gun optic, which are currently on fielded weapon systems out across the Army and the Marine Corps. So we talked with some experts at the Army who are developing this program and will be implementing the fire control system about the capabilities, what this is going to do for soldiers they don't currently have, and what opportunities exist in the future.
There's a number of error budgets that you have when a soldier's engaging a target. You know, the soldier's level of proficiency, his inputs, muscular, breathing, nervousness, being under fire certainly does present itself with an awful lot of stress, and the ability to calm your mind, engage the target correctly, apply your principles of marksmanship are most important. Secondary, and probably the biggest error budget that we could technically help mitigate is range estimation. You know, on a standard range where it's 50, 100, 150, 200, you know what your holds are. If the guy's at 347 meters or 289, there's a big difference there. And soldiers having the ability to laser target very quickly, get an adjusted reticle aim point, and pull the trigger has shown that it is going to increase the probability of hit in the future.
So the future capabilities of this particular system, both the weapon and the optic, are really pretty broad. The Army is also developing the integrated visual augmentation system, a really futuristic night vision goggle that does thermal, does navigation, can communicate wirelessly within the squad, and also upload data to a platoon or company level cloud. With this optic, it'll talk to that system in the future, and so you basically have an opportunity to see the view of the soldier from the rifle at the company level or beyond. And also within the squad, if you need to kind of show your squad leader who's at a different position on the patrol what you're seeing, you can give them eyes on through your own weapon and through your goggle system once those things are integrated. All the data sharing, all the navigation, all the computer elements are interesting, but the key is it's going to really increase marksmanship, is what experts say. Basically, it's going to walk someone onto a target and give them the capabilities within their own individual service weapon or squad level weapon that have existed in big systems like the Abrams tank or the Bradley fighting vehicle or the Stryker for years, taking those computer type systems down into a goggle, down into an optic that make that individual weapon of that individual soldier on the battlefield extremely accurate, precise, and also a data gathering tool. Not every soldier or Marine is going to get this optic. It's going to the close combat forces first. So think special operations, infantry, and those support aspects of infantry in the close combat fight, such as scouts or combat engineers. So the next thing we'll be looking for is the Army's selection of which next generation squad weapon prototype they're going to use. That's going to happen later this year. I'm Todd South, reporting for Military Times.